Welcome to a new episode of Grab and Go. Today, we are going to discuss the recent District Court judgment of Kan Kin Tong versus Man Leong Fire Services Limited. This case talks about the true nature of the bonus scheme. The claimant was a defendant company's employee. The company and the employee entered into a bonus agreement, which stated that the bonus payments are to be made to the employee every 6 months at a certain percentage based on the achievement of a net profit target, and that the payment is subject to the final decision of the company. Except for the net profit target, the agreement is silent on the conditions for bonus payment or the circumstances under which company would exercise its discretion not to pay the bonus. Amongst other matters, the court found that the purpose of the bonus was so that the employee could share 50% of the net profit with the company. The employee and all other employees of the company had over all years of employment been paid the half-yearly bonuses solely based on the agreed percentage of the achieved net profit. And it would be wholly unreasonable for the company to not have mentioned any bonus payment criteria or condition for exercising its discretion had there been intended any discretion at all. The court therefore found that the bonus is contractual in nature. The two takeaways from this case are that even if a bonus is labeled as a discretionary bonus, if in practice the bonus is paid as long as the performance target is hit, then the bonus is in fact contractual in nature. Even if a bonus is discretionary in nature, this does not mean that the employer could exercise his discretion perversely. Instead, it is implied that the employer must exercise his discretion in good faith. Stay tuned for the next episode.